Somewhere in the countryside of Northumberland, surrounded by an impromptu winter wonderland, the story of our trip to England 2019 begins.
So we were supposed to start our day today in Bamborough Castle, is that right? And yeah, it was kind of pissing rain, so there was no point in even getting the cameras out. So a local guy here, his name is John Haswell. John!
Hello!
How's it going, man?
It's very snowy.
Yes. Where are we?
Annakmua.
There you go. I couldn't.
Is he only doing this because he can't actually say it?
I can't even say it, yeah. So we're somewhere in Northumberland, yeah. And as you can see, it is snowing really, really nice. So we've come to a place here, which is a lime kiln. And we're going to try and take some shots of that. It's definitely different to what I'd planned. It's not even going to be by the coast. So it's beautiful here. The roads themselves as well are covered in snow, but we're still able to get here. Getting out now though might be a different question, yeah? So, John, what have we got to shoot up here?
Well, there's obviously the lime kiln that we're going to do now. There is a lone tree a little bit further down that I've shot before.
Okay.
If we had the clear sky, it would be awesome doing the Cheviot Hills, because when they're covered in snow, it's absolutely amazing, but there's no way on earth we're going to see them. So we're quite limited for what we can actually shoot. Once we've done these two, we'll probably just have a wander, see if we can find some local compositions. On this little corner here, there's a kind of little stream, some okay. sheep and that, so we'll find something good.
Excellent. So yeah, I've got a good local guide here to get us through it. So yeah, we'll check back in again once we arrive to the first plot we're going to shoot anyway. But yeah, definitely a winter wonderland and definitely unexpected. So we're no sooner into this area here, and I've stopped already, because in the distance here with the snow, you've got a nice road that's leading up. And it does really give a nice shot, I do think. I've got the camera here, and there's the composition that I'm looking at. And at the moment here, I'm shooting at f14 at a 30th of a second, and I'm at ISO 100. And as you can see here, it's a nice kind of a scene, the way it leads you through the image as well itself. But yeah, we're going to get some nice snow-covered shots, I think, here. We'll have a look around and get to the next spot, but yeah, maybe I'll be stopping quite often, we'll see. It is really, really, really a white out here, and even all around us, there's lots of things to shoot, but at the same time, there's nothing to shoot, because you kind of want to have something that's going to be separated out on its own in this white. And behind me, you've got the structure, and what I've done here is come over with the camera, and you can see there's a bit of logs that are remaining on the ground there. So even though I just have the 70-200 on, the reason I have 70-200 on is because it has the lens hood. So it'll stop any water, technically speaking, getting on the front of the lens as well itself. But with that lens, I now have to go at 70, but also do multiple shots to be able to get everything into the frame. So I've taken four shots here. I'll probably stitch them together later in post, but it's a lovely spot. The snow, the way it's sitting as well on the trees that are on top of the structure, is really, really nice. And I've gotten one or two other little candid shots as well around here, so if they work out, I'll show you those photos as well here. So we're going to head away now to another spot close by to here, so yeah, we'll check back in then when we get to that point. Whoop! We've moved along here now to a location that John actually has tipped us off about. It's a lone tree that you can see here behind me. And in this whiteout, it actually will give a lovely photograph, I do think. It's all on its own, it's in the middle of a field, but with the snow and everything else as well, you'll see nothing in the background, so it'll really be isolated out on its own. And the guys are here just composing a shot, as you can see, and there's a bit of a log on the ground. Now, I'm using still on my 70-200, and I want to stick on that. I'm not going to change my lens, so I'm just going to go for a simple shot here, which is just the tree on its own, standing out, like I say, purely kind of a minimalist or a simplistic shot as well itself, without any distractions whatsoever. It's a beautiful spot. I think we're going to have snow, looks like, for the day as well here. So, yeah, we're going to crack on here and take this shot, and I'll check in a moment here if I find a nice composition, and I'll talk you through the type of shot that I'm taking. I'm on handheld as well, so I've left the tripod in the car. So yeah, get this photograph anyway here, and I'll talk you through in a moment. Now I've come over here to where the guys were a moment ago with this log that you can see here in front of me, and I'm still using the long lens, but I was able to go back far enough to be able to get the log in the foreground and the tree as well in the background. And I'm shooting at the moment at f11, and I'm at about 1/150th of a second, and it's allowing me to get a quick enough shutter speed, so I'm not getting any blur in the shot as well itself. But it's a really, really nice tree, don't you think? I think the shot as well itself would be really, really nice, but yeah, it's definitely a surprise, completely different to what we thought we would be shooting this morning at the beach and the castle. But so yeah, for now anyway, we're going to take this shot, and I think that's probably going to end this section of my vlog in the snow. We'll see, we might get somewhere else, but if not, I'm going to sign out now. So until the next time, thanks very much for watching, and shlonga for. Ha 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 ha!